Wisconsin came to West Lafayette looking to keep a winning streak alive and set up a big-time showdown next week at Nebraska. The Badgers will head home to having done just that after a 34-16 win over Purdue, the team's fourth straight victory. Trailing 3-0 in the first quarter, the Badgers looked to their Heisman candidate, Melvin Gordon, to get things started, and he did so with a 14-yard touchdown run for a 7-3 lead. Purdue and Wisconsin would trade field goals, the Badgers coming after a 47-yard run from Gordon, when Rafael Gaglianone chipped in a 24-yard field goal for a 10-6 lead. The Badgers would close the half with back-to-back touchdowns, the first coming on a 27-yard touchdown pass from Joel Stavi to Melvin Gordon. It was capped off by a highlight reel hurdle into the end zone. The second touchdown was a 9-yard pass from Stavi to Alex Erickson, capping off a drive in which Stave went 7-for-7 for 68 yards just before intermission. The Boilermakers would get some momentum back in the second half and cut the score to just 8 points on a 79-yard touchdown pass from Appleby to Hunt. But after Purdue successfully recovered an onside kick, a replay review overturned the call and gave Wisconsin back the football. Wisconsin would not relinquish control after that, as Tanner McAvoy scored on a 13-yard touchdown run to make it a two-score game, and Gaglianone chipped in his second field goal of the day, providing the final cushion of 34-16. UW used a balanced effort offensively, finishing with 489 yards total, including 264 on the ground and 225 through the air. The Badgers' defense continued its stingy ways, holding the Boilermakers to just 230 total yards and a mere 25 on the ground. Melvin Gordon racked up 205 yards rushing and 249 all-purpose, including two touchdowns. Vince Beagle was the star of the defense, posting three sacks and four tackles for loss.
Coming on the road, winning the Big Ten on the road is not easy, so coming out here in a tough environment, is always good for our team.
At halftime, Gary Anderson said in an interview that he wanted more pressure on the quarterback second half. He was disappointed with it. What was the message in the locker room? Because you guys sure turned up the tempo in the second half.
Yeah, brought some more blitzes, had me come on a few more inside blitzes, so that really paid off for me. Able to get to the passer, and my defensive lineman made it easy for me.
At what point in that second half did you realize that you could get to the quarterback seemingly whenever you wanted?
Well, I think we were getting pressure in there, but it was kind of the inside moves that was really helping me. So being able to put those inside blitzes in there was really beneficial to our defense, and paid off with three sacks for myself.
Next Saturday, Nebraska, Camp Randall. What do you think about that?
Attention's full in Nebraska right now. We're excited for the huge opportunity. Nebraska's a great team. I know they're coming off a bye week here, so they're prepping for us, and we're going to go tomorrow, watch a film, and Nebraska all the way this week.
Wisconsin moves to 7-2 overall and 4-1 in the Big Ten and sets up a big-time showdown with Big Ten West rival Nebraska, who comes to Camp Randall at 8-1 and 4-1 in the Big Ten. That's all from West Lafayette, Indiana, where the Badgers win 34-16. Stay with UWBadgers.com for complete coverage leading into the game with Nebraska.